Okay, I got the Nocta 4's core with the 11x7 double D coil. Just want to do a quick nail test here on the deck. I got a nickel on edge right here. I don't know if you can see it or not, but it's right here in the crack. And I got a dime stuck right here on the edge. And this machine is going to be in two-tone with the tone break set at 40. Let me turn it on. Get this thing on. Okay. It's set on 50 sensitivity. It's in DI2. And I'll let you hear the nails here, Derek. They'll be the grunt. Now, this is how powerful this machine is. Listen to how it'll overload them nails if you get too close. See, I'm still a couple inches above them. So, it does have a lot of power. Even actually when I was in the iron with the small coil, I didn't go much above 50 and it still had great depth. So, okay, here's the nickel. No problem on the nickel. And here's the dime. And the ID's jumping up to... Every once in a while, you'll see the 83 in there if you'll watch. But on the nickel... doing about 46 or so. And nickel reads about 54. So... on the dime, doing about the same. Every once in a while you'll see a upper 80s jump in, or a mid 80s jump in there, but you gotta watch the mid 80s because a nail can read there too at certain times if you just keep playing with it, so you know, on the faults. But what I find interesting on the machine is though the tone's breaking at 40, when I start adding the ID mask, it'll get to where you would think, let me show you what I'm talking about. It'll get to where I'm in mode DI2. So I come down to the iron mask, it's in 10. But now the tone doesn't break to 40. So if I run this up to 40 just to silence the nails, it's doing something else in the programming too. Now the nickel, we can still hear it. But you can tell the nickel's starting to get chopped. So that's the problem when you start silencing the iron. Any machine's about like that, but I notice on this machine, when you start silencing the iron, it'll start clipping the high targets. Now watch on this dime. See how much of the tone's gone now? But if I run it back down to let the low tone flow with the high tone, you know, just let it run together, I'll run it back down. If you go below 10 on this, you're getting into the mineral. And so if you're out in the woods and you're below 10, you'll start hearing rocks and stuff like that. So I usually just leave it on 10 unless I want some full side analysis, then I'll run it down to zero. But now we're back on the 10. Hear how much better that nickel sounds? And this dime's gonna sound better. It opens the audio back up. And that's a good reason to always just let the audio flow. When you start silencing parts of the audio, you can see it starts clipping targets. I'm gonna try to get out and do my depth test here in a few minutes, but in the yard. But I just thought I would show this real quick, and I might ought to put that little small coil. I'll do the small coil in another test. Okay. All right. Appreciate it.